Guru Padra Sarvasiddhi Guru Guru Santa mente la mia mente, oh Padre.
La tua santa mente la mia mente, oh Padre.
Your holy mind and my mind, oh Father.
Your holy mind and my mind, oh Father.
Io mi dico,
possano i tuoi santi corpo, parole e mente diventare inseparabili dai miei.
Possano i tuoi santi corpo, parole e mente diventare inseparabili dai miei.
May your holy body, speech and mind become inseparable from mine.
May your holy body, speech and mind become inseparable from mine.
Ma che ti puda anche lui.
Ma che ti puda anche
lui. Il tuo santo corpo, mio corpo, madre.
Il tuo santo corpo, mio corpo, madre.
Your holy body, my body, oh madre.
Your holy body, my body, oh madre.
Ma che ti insegna anche lui.
Ma perché sudanda vita?
La tua santa parola è la mia parola, oh madre.
La tua santa parola è la mia parola, oh madre.
Your holy speech and my speech, oh mother.
Your holy speech and my speech, oh madre.
Ma che tu danda vita?
Ma perché tu danda vita?
La tua santa mente è la mia mente, oh madre.
La tua santa mente è la mia mente, oh madre.
Your holy mind and my mind, oh mother.
Your holy mind and my mind, oh mother.
E io mi chiedo il cingilo.
Possano i tuoi santi corpo, parole e mente diventare inseparabili dai miei.
Possano i tuoi santi corpo, parole e mente diventare inseparabili dai miei.
May your holy body, speech and mind become inseparable from mine.
May your holy body, speech and mind become inseparable from mine.
Om Muni Muni Maha Muni Shakyamuni Soha.
Om Muni Muni Maha Muni Shakyamuni Soha.
Buonasera.
Buonasera.
Buonasera. Buonasera. So, la... Tutto mi no? Yes. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Tutti i giorni after the New Year, I've been to Middle News, I've been to Nepal, Kathmandu, which is Shudu Dara, together with Shudu Miracle Mantra, Ashoka Muni Buddhas. So I've been to the Tibetan New Year, or Chinese New Year. I've been to the Abhi place, which is Brother Nadamir in June, which is the Kanjan Dugan, who make it a call to South India. Many more spoke to me, many people surrounded him and so many ceremonies. Then after all that puja and so on, then after they been to Dugan, into Palan, which is also originally, what you call now, was a visiting country. So I've been to Dhammapaya from Dhammapaya, Dhammapaya. Many people to make a Maka Puja to and for children, not only that, children, many education to be new tribes. So I think this one will try for this. And the children then also their request to Rama Mission is give to teaching, which is, you know, Theravada. This mind is very deep, every year, mind in Tamil. Ajayantana is Theravada Dhammaka is open to permission to keep teaching there one day. So, you know, they are important, you know, who knows English professional and great, high level, everybody listening to Dhamma's teaching. It is very historically for beneficial exchange each other is very important. So this after that I've been to also, you know, usually retreat, looking for permits to be good, which is, you know, his mandala in ancient history is one thing. And it still remains to show him to how the Bhumi path is to be enlightened. So where, you know, your desires for, you know, interactions. And with this, Lalitabhutan Dodzanglam's history is showing one. Over there, you know, Gandhavyara, you know, 50 gurus, one person, you know, one single person to look after some time, took to Tibetan gurus, which means not only headquarters, traditional gurus, monks, took to Tibetan gurus, lay persons, Romans, and even Buddhists, took to teaching to Bhumi, or the Buddhism teachers, given very high level practitioners, but meant to not you, normal, simple, their practitioners. So this one, Gandhavyara, the person who got out of teaching, in his place, yes, yes. Any false high level, and the man just showed the temple here, and where the man just chakras, all kinds of showing to people. You know, we are here, let's go out of here, and Banyan Wanali, 8 months. Guru Buddha explained to thousand mandalas to be different possible, to practice it possible. This kind of thing showing, so, what do you do? Do it. No need to. Do it. So this kind of more than 200 palaces. Lalitabhutan Wanali, 20 palaces. So things like this ancient history. So we are going there to learn, to blessing, to initiation. But this means retreat is how called many things we can. Conferences. There's you know, to speak it. Which is parents, which is very necessary now, people living at parents there. To look in one way, also this way, the kind of things. Particular, you know, very difficult to go, you know, even Buddhism to one each other, difficult to go is in the temple. And Hindu, Muslim, we never go to that, maybe Hindu temple, go something, Muslim temple, we never go into Muslim.
Mosque.
Mosque, we never go. But the Buddha is special. Buddhism is maybe like very rare, short, less people. Muslims go, Muslims. So this is particular book, you know, is how open to blessing true for, of course, originally is Buddhism country, but now, even now today, even ancient time also offer homage to Buddha, you know, all the religion, Hindu, whatever Buddhism, everyone in Japan, now also, before they are going to smoke, no normal smoke. Going to limit people on this one side into the Shia Muslims, maybe different. And maybe tourists, doesn't matter. Even tourists never come to Muslim temple. It's a very special, very powerful, very compassion. Power means love and compassion for so everyone. So that's why our early morning start to 4:30 in 5:31. We need the true proof. So it's very particular, you know, you have to think this way. This is very difficult to happen. It's not only one day, 2 days, you know, they pay ticket, you know. Pay ticket to a lot of money that go and move to the house. So it's very particular. So we are going to each year. Some years I thought maybe I'm not possible to go because I am old man and so on, but then I have to ask now. Also, we don't come, it's going to pension. But it's no pension. It's no pension here. So, I am 75 years old, no pension, full. So I'm trying to go. Something is true, and what is maybe is better than before. So, when we die in these days, in this month, you see, I'm no serious to die. No sick. So it's very good to be my body, everything is fine. But what we do need to be understanding each time more understanding. Each time more business, each time more feeling, each time more alcohol. Then we give it to elephants and each day, given to some elephants, so happy, you know. That was so happy to receive, to give to his every day. Then I go to this time, I've been to a little bit elephant go around. They are so nice to me. Usually sometimes they are a little bit. You meet to go down. There's no need, I mean, usually need one place to go up and another size to go. I did just my hotel, which I tried to do, go down to the city, go to every place. So all kind of things, even elephants, even you know, those people are so nice to us. So also something working with children, helping, like dinner and so on. So many people want to be a little bit more animal, Switzerland, Allah and so on. So also we try to do more for them. Please, one day we're going to be many. We have 200 people nearly. So everybody will buy horses, horse bags. We try to participate for many village people not happy in the receipt. So kind of things, they say, I like to say something, because you wonder what happens in this life, and what models. So it's what news is, not only that, our dedication to all this in our prison, we try to help, and many dedication our mission to all these people, very much ask to Allah. This and that, and my wish, this and that. So I can be taking care of all those issues. So we have sick people, we have dying people, and you say, what can we do? So we're doing something about oil, fire, electric plant, life, how our works is. So we're doing so successful. Now we come back to market also on retreat. Light, we did also many people. Love, we have a lot of retreat, which is a lot of issues in the chair, in the chair, and building what most people go into again. Sunday night starts with this retreat. You know, why are we a little more open? Why we should not just stick to this cross-section and so on. You know, I don't know if I'm closest to life, I don't know if this. So, especially underneath to be, I don't know, especially we have to be. But you know, otherwise, we have to discover the great. After that, we have Saturday. We have five of that. I think this is what they have to say. Minus, what happened. Today, it was just love. Tomorrow, I was teaching us, I was sent to teach in the computer, which is now a chance for us. Imagine this week, I just go English too.
I have to learn. Quindi, allora, dopo il nuovo anno, nel 2015 la Magan ci dice voglio parlarvi un po' di quello che ho fatto, perché comunque diciamo al giorno d'oggi le persone vogliono sapere un po' le novità, quindi il nuovo anno occidentale l'ho passato qui e poi sono andato a passare il nuovo anno, che in questo caso era in concomitanza il nuovo anno cinese, il nuovo anno tibetano, come tutti gli anni in Nepal. E quel primo mese dell'anno è dedicato a un mese speciale, perché è il mese in cui Buddha ha manifestato per 15 giorni dei miracoli, e quindi c'è un particolare giorno dedicato a questo. Comunque abbiamo come sempre invitato dal sud dell'India a molti monaci, per fare tutta una serie di puja, di cerimonie, di lavare il cielo, la puja di lunga vita, eccetera, eccetera. Quindi tutto questo programma si è svolto a Kathmandu con successo. Poi dopo 15 giorni, dalla luna nuova, che è l'inizio dell'anno, c'è stata, come tutti gli anni, la cerimonia della luna piena in Thailandia, Bangkok. Thailandia è un altro paese buddista, e lì sono appunto partecipato a questa grande cerimonia Maha Puja si chiama, che è appunto una cerimonia in cui partecipano migliaia di monaci e migliaia di persone, e in concomitanza con questi giorni alla Dharmakaya Foundation sono state poi delle premiazioni, perché ci sono un programma educativo, quindi vengono dati premi, mi hanno fatto consegnare anche a me un premio ai bambini, e poi lì che comunque quella tradizione fa parte della corrente Theravada, e normalmente diciamo dal punto di vista Theravada non vengono accettati in generale Mahayana, Tantrayana, Vajrayana, eccetera, eccetera, ma nel caso loro questa Dharmakaya sono molto aperti, quindi hanno invitato, credo per la seconda volta, già comunque venite quelle più volte, forse la sesta volta che la Michelle Ribu ci viene invitato per dare insegnamenti, quindi un giorno dedicato a questo, e dice questo la Michelle parla inglese molto, molto bene, quindi una cosa che poi è messa a anche dalle loro televisioni, che è un tipo di scambio molto importante, storico, e quindi questo è successo anche quest'anno. Dopodiché da lì siamo andati in Indonesia, a Borobudur, dove esiste questo enorme monumento, che è il più grande stupa mandala buddista, dove vengono appunto mostrati vari livelli della pratica per il raggiungimento dell'illuminazione. Ci sono le direzioni legate ai Dhyani Buddha, ai cinque Dhyani Buddha, e poi ci sono questi pannelli, questi bassorilievi molto molto accurati, con una, diciamo, una raffinatezza artistica molto alta, e in questi pannelli vengono mostrati differenti sutra tradizionali buddhisti, uno la Lalita Vistara e l'altro il Gandavihua. E in questo Gandavihua, la storia del Gandavihua è la storia di come un personaggio della storia buddista si era affidato a differenti maestri, sia monaci che laici, anche in varie forme, in varie manifestazioni, come prostitute e altri tipi di esseri che comunque avevano altre realizzazioni e mostravano l'insegnamento. Quindi questo è un altro degli esempi di come appunto a volte l'insegnamento, la pratica può venire a differenti livelli. Comunque, diciamo, questo stupa si è preservato nei millenni, è un posto storico, e all'interno di questo stupa si possono applicare le pratiche di Guhya Samaja, di Chakrasambhava, di Kalachakra, come a Borobudur dal Bagnano ci sono 108 mandala, così lì si possono in realtà praticare migliaia di mandala. E questi pannelli sono molti, nel senso che quelli del Gandavihua sono più di 200, mentre quelli della Lalita Vistara sono 120. E quindi nel corso del programma, in realtà, in questo posto si sale molto presto per differenti ragioni, una quella climatica e l'altra è quella che adesso in questo momento è diventato un posto molto famoso, visitato da molti molti turisti, e quindi dopo una certa ora si riempie. Quindi noi salivamo molto presto, poi scendevamo in questa sala di conferenze e c'erano persone che parlavano poi della loro esperienza, insegnamenti, pratiche, iniziazioni e varie cose. Una delle cose molto speciale, a mio parere, che normalmente tra le differenti correnti religiose, induista, musulmana, buddista, no, non ci sono degli scambi, ma non è che si va nei templi delle altre tradizioni, in particolare l'Islam, sono molto stretti su questo. Tuttavia, questo stupa di Borobudur, che comunque ha come energia quella dell'amore e della compassione, ha una condizione speciale, perché in realtà moltissime scolaresche, moltissime l'Indonesia è il più grande paese islamico nel mondo, era un paese buddista in origine, comunque diciamo ogni giorno ci sono migliaia di visitatori, anche appunto indonesiani, che vanno a visitare scolaresche e pagano un biglietto abbastanza caro per loro, e tuttavia appunto questo posto ed è comunque rispettato, nel senso che per esempio una volta non c'era divieto di fumare, adesso non si può più fumare allo stupa, eccetera eccetera, quindi questa cosa qui vuol dire che comunque c'è un senso dell'importanza di quel posto. Comunque, diciamo, noi facevamo questa pratica, e poi c'era questo programma molto molto intenso, c'è stato anche lì Ramanchemo, eccetera eccetera. Quindi dice, io è molti anni che vado in questo posto, adesso ho 75 anni, cioè dovrei essere in pensione, ma in realtà ci lavoro ancora molto, e penso di che il mio corpo...
What are you? Your woman?
Dice, non è che... E anch'io vorrei andare in pensione, non solo voi. Dice che io comunque il mio corpo mi sostiene, perché comunque sono ancora forte, in buona salute, quindi dice che in questo senso questa cosa ci terrei a portarla avanti negli anni. Perché comunque è una cosa che rende le persone molto molto felici, che veramente c'è un grosso cambiamento nella mente delle persone che visitano questo posto, che fanno questo ritiro. Poi dice, abbiamo come intorno in questo parco di Borgudur ci sono questi elefanti che noi tutte le mattine andavamo a visitare, quindi portiamo tutte le mattine del cibo per gli elefanti, quindi poi abbiamo fatto anche questo giro sugli elefanti. Dice che normalmente bisogna andare lì in un certo posto per salire sull'elefante, nel mio caso sono venuti a prendermi all'hotel, gli elefanti si sono abbassati per farmi salire, quindi una giornata molto, molto speciale. Poi ci sono stati anche lì l'Anna Vogt, che è una nostra amica svizzera, che ultimamente lavora, fa delle attività per i bambini in Indonesia, e quindi dice, abbiamo anche lì collaborato, sostenuto questo tipo di progetto, e dice, e abbiamo poi, ci siamo un giorno, siamo andati a visitare la zona dell'intorno, tutti con con i cavalli, eccetera, eccetera. Comunque abbiamo, diciamo, le persone ci accolgono molto bene, sono molto contente di vederci, e quindi come sempre abbiamo fatto tantissime cose dedicate alla pace nel mondo, alla pace interiore, eccetera, eccetera, e diciamo questo progetto anche di aiutare persone malate, persone morenti, eccetera, eccetera, persone in situazioni economiche difficili, continua ad essere appunto portato avanti. Poi al ritorno c'è stato subito un ritiro di Kurukula, un weekend di Kurukula, in cui hanno partecipato molte persone, e c'è stata una notte intera di pratica dedicata a Kurukula, e poi il giorno dopo, la domenica, ci sono stati tre tipi di puja del fuoco, la puja del fuoco di pacificazione, quella di potere e quella di incremento. E adesso, diciamo, c'è in programma questo ritiro molto stretto della Michelle con Dushan Rinpoche, Tenzin, e questo ritiro è un ritiro stretto che inizia alla mattina presto, con quattro sessioni durante la giornata, e appunto l'impostazione sarà quella di un ritiro tradizionale, durerà 5 giorni, poi sabato ci sarà la puja del fuoco. Questo per quanto riguarda le novità. Adesso questo weekend ad Albagnano, cioè sabato e domenica, ci sarà il corso sul commentario della Guru Puja di Lama Michel. So, Raganci, say I want to relate what I've been doing, because people like very much to receive news. So after spending the New Year Eve here in Italy, I went to celebrate Tibetan New Year, which this year was together with the Chinese New Year in Nepal. And always we do these ceremonies by inviting many monks from the south of India to do different practice ceremonies, Ramna Chemo and Long Life Puja, and so on. And this first month of the year is a particular month because it's the month historically which celebrate the miracle of Buddha at the time. So it is a special month for practice. And so we did all this after after 15 days I've been to Bangkok, to Thailand, which is also a Buddhist country, and in the full moon day at the Dharmakaya, Dharmakaya Foundation park, we have this Maha Puja ceremony of the full moon, which with thousands of people, thousands of monks, and completely millions of people, thousands of monks. And so we did this very impressive ceremony, and then there were other related ceremonies, like for example they give prize for students because we have an educational system, so myself I was asked to give a prize to students, and then which is something very rare because normally there is not this kind of exchange between the Theravada and the Mahayana Vajrayana tradition. They ask Lama Michel to give teachings, so already it happens a few times, six times that Lama Michel gave teaching in English, and the television is broadcasting that, so it's very important historical occasion that. Then after that we go normally to Borobudur in Indonesia, where there is this, the largest stupa mandala in the world, and so which somehow show the path to enlightenment by revealing the different bhumis and paths and the different directions with the Buddhas and so on. And then there is this panel strike, this bas-relief, which are panels with the history of Buddha and with specifically two sutras, Lalita Vishtara and Gandavihua. And so these panels, Lalita Vishtara is 120 panels, Gandavihua more than 200. And it tells, for example, Gandavihua tells the story of a practitioner that went to relate to different gurus in different form, in a monk form, an ordinary form, even in prostitute form, or different kind of approach to the Dharma. Anyway, these are historical sutra, and ourselves, we practice our own self-healing, and it is the different tantras can be applied to the structure of the stupa, like Guhya Samaja, Chakrasambhara, Talachakra, and so on. So, as much as in Malvagnano, for example, we have these Anduhandagri mandalas, in Borobudur we can apply 1,000 mandala practice, and so we have this possibility to accede to this place. But this place now is very popular for the tourists to visit, and even Indonesian tourists, so we need to go very early in the morning, like 4:30, and go there in the early mornings before people arrive. So we do the practice there, then we come down, there is a special conference hall where many people relate their own experience, which is important, because now, nowadays people are more interested in experiences than just knowledge. And so we have this conference, teachings, initiations, different kind of program, and the Ramya Shema also with the monks. And this is, we need to consider that Indonesia is the largest Muslim country, but at the same time it was originally Buddhist, and so there, somehow there is this special karma, you know, to the kindness and loving kindness of all the Buddhas, that this stupa is visited by many, many Muslim people, and many students also from Indonesia, they come, they pay the ticket, they stay there all day. So it is a special blessing that they can receive to this place, and also this place is treated with respect, because before one could smoke there, and now there is a prohibition for smoking, and so it's treated really like a temple. So this is really something quite unusual, quite special. And ourselves, like, we were more than 170 people, and we go there every year since many years. Now I'm 75, but my body is still strong, so I hope to be able to continue to do that. Now, there's normally in our own society, we go to retirement after after a certain age. Me, I'm still working, I'm still fully with full energy and so on, so I want to continue that. Anyway, in the Borobudur Park, there are elephants too, which we going to visit every morning. We bring food, so they're very happy. And we had an elephant ride, and this also was special because normally you need to go there and you need to go on a certain platform to go on the elephant, but in that case the elephant went to the hotel to take me, so they had to kneel down, and so it was something also very auspicious, very special. Plus there is Anna Vogt there doing a project with children, so also we went to visit. We are going to give our own support to that. And also we make village people that are very hospitable, and they are very happy to see us. So we went one day to visit the place around with the horses and charts and so on. So it was somehow all very auspicious and always dedicated for inner peace, for peace and so on. And so we go on doing this kind of activities. And when I came back after, in Italy, there was this Kurukula retreat for and also the Singha Mukha Samaraj practice. And we did a night to Kurukula on Saturday and Sunday. We had the three types of fire puja, the peaceful fire puja, the increasing fire puja, and the powerful fire puja.
So now, now in the next after Sunday, actually this weekend there will be Michelle teaching on the Guru Puja commentary, and then Sunday evening we start a very strict retreat on Tirupulla, which Lama Michelle will be held in, which Lama Michelle will be there, and Tenzin also, and there will be starting the early morning, 4 session a day of strict practice, and so, and then Saturday, next Saturday there will be and their fire puja, and so these are the news of what's been going on and what is going to happen.
Yeah, that time we have also. Originally, have Pascal time, also doing that in 4 days. So anyway, thank you very much. Many participants from Nepal, a lot of strong message and so on. And they're spending so-and-so is very much to me. For mine is, we need our art element in this paper to continue. Without water, we develop because we need for people. There is, you know, his system to be normal and the system to be very positive. And space to keep us for a while, so in the dedication for this is so important. And you know, ancient time, built, you know, it's an 8th century time. Now we are, you know, people who are very final, make to, that time, you know, thinking to people visiting. That time is kingdoms visiting, you know, much people, you know, so there's, you know, we say all knowing one, fusion meaning. So it's perfect now for people being to receive, to be example. With their own stone. So it's not an example. Now with this knowledge being here, you know, this one is good with those mandala. It's easy to understand very what, how we took, there is took the stone. There is no color, but we have developed Buddhism knowledge base, so this could be the Buddhism mandala. So, yeah, so I think we have our very good knowledge, also singing, but some dream, making some money, doing, you know, all these things, and you know, nomination giving, Lama Prabhupada's giving to very much injury. So, deep meanings and large and so on. So you see something is happening with, you know, with the knowledge in itself is recommended to you in this talk. Go there. So you can, but we know now. So you see, we are very lucky. So, and Pandit Guru Court is in particular place, and now not going to like to take this way. Anyway, now we have our council is very it has a Buddhism movie in beginning from the inside, now is it is working for Europe, particularly Italian. So we hope also we have been work on this. 23. Next one means we have Ubi. Ubi, we have ceremony in Milano. Whatever this date is, I don't remember. And then there's something we have each Buddhism doing somewhere. So we have the island here. So we have to be. This is, you know, Buddhism is maybe fusion is maybe okay for everything within society or for. What we now is we have to be ourselves to be all this expensive. Something What we're going to do also this is with the same mandala and our practicings, teachings, and Augustine, you know. Now we are manifesting that time offering to the probably which is the Sarsubhagosa where all this meaning is repeating is single is the meaning, you know. So things happening then we have this we have our Bhakti time. Also we have now Buddhism movie time, and then we have one more, maybe it's export time, maybe it's export time. Maybe everywhere, so it's new, our goal is very new to do the things.
Quindi volevo anche ringraziare per chi ha contribuito per la lunga vita, rifugio di lunga vita in Nepal, e poi anche ricordiamo che ci sarà questo ritiro di cui è Samaja a Pasqua. Comunque diciamo è per me molto importante dedicare energia affinché l'equilibrio planetario degli elementi si ristabilisca, quindi l'elemento terra, l'elemento acqua, gli elementi sono così fondamentali perché sono la base, il fondamento della nostra esistenza, quindi è molto importante che si preservino. E dice, allo stesso modo questo stupa si è mantenuto nei secoli, dal VII secolo è rimasto, e se pensiamo quanto è grande è stato fatto in un'epoca in cui probabilmente era visitato da persone, era un reame, un regno, eccetera, quindi probabilmente era visitato da persone un po' particolari, però è come se la saggezza onnisciente di chi ha progettato questo pensasse al futuro, adesso che sono migliaia e migliaia di persone ogni giorno che vanno a visitare questo stupo, questo posto. Comunque dice, questo è fatto di pietra lavica, e quindi adesso non è colorato, però diciamo capire il significato di questo richiede un certo tipo di conoscenza. Noi abbiamo la fortuna e il privilegio di poter accedere a queste conoscenze, e qui abbiamo fatto questo pannello a nostra volta, quello luminoso che vedete qui, anche qui rappresenta la pratica, lo stupa di Borobudur con i differenti simboli e divinità e le pratiche connesse alle varie direzioni, di cui poi la Magna Michela mi hanno dato molte spiegazioni, molti commentari, e la possibilità appunto di applicare a pratiche di autoguarigione tantrica, di realizzare la pace con l'ambiente che tutti noi conosciamo molto bene. Poi c'è questo fatto che ci sono alcune interpretazioni che dicono questo posto era Dhanakkota, dove Buddha ha dato gli insegnamenti esoterici di Kalachakra. Comunque adesso oggi c'è questo programma al Kumbh Mela Ganchen qui a Milano. Kumbh Mela Ganchen fa parte dell'Unione Buddhista Italiana, è stato uno dei centri fondatore dell'Unione Buddhista Italiana, e in questo senso ci sono anche dei progetti prossimi a venire. In maggio ci sarà una giornata dedicata all'attività del Centro dell'Unione Buddhista Italiana, che adesso è stato riconosciuto ufficialmente dallo Stato, quindi ci saranno questi spazi in città per i vari centri, quindi noi cercheremo di fare molte cose in questo contesto, per esempio la mandala di sabbia, iniziazioni, insegnamenti, l'orchestra Sarasvati che appunto si potrà in questo senso manifestare, quindi questo è un programma appunto molto importante. Poi ci sarà anche la possibilità
di presentare il Nelso Sarasvati Orchestra all'Expo di Milano. So, so also I would like to thank the people who contributed with the donation to the Long Life Puja in Nepal, and also announced that in for Easter holidays there will be the, there will be this course on Guhya Samaja with the Namakkaran and Ganchen. And then what we do normally is always dedicated to the rebalancing of the environment, because it's very important that the environment is not upside down and the elements are balanced, so especially the element earth will sustain the life of beings, but all the elements are very fundamental. Without water, without air, you'll not be able to breathe, to exist. So all these elements should be kept stable and clean and so on. So we always dedicate for that. And we think about this stupa of Borobudur, which has been preserved since the 7th century and is so huge, you know, I mean, maybe at the time it was built, not so many people were visiting it because it was a kingdom and maybe only special people allowed to go there, but somehow there was some kind of foreknowledge, we say omniscience by the side of those who thought about that and projected that. So now, after many centuries, this place is still there, and it is meant for many people who visit it, which actually are every day going to visit and to get the blessing of that place. So there is some kind of special idea about that. So this monument is made of stone. Nowadays it's not color, so we need to understand the meaning of it, and we have the privilege and the capacity to understand it. And so we made also this panel, which you see, the luminous panel here, is also depicting the various Dhyani Buddha's practices, symbols connected to Borobudur and connected to the practice of self-healing, making peace with the environment, which we know well. Lama Michelle and Lama Caroline have given many commentaries and explanation on that. So we are very lucky, plus this place, according to certain interpretation, it's considered to be Dhanakot, where Buddha Shakyamuni has revealed the Kalachakra Tantra. Anyway, so we have now Kumbhalama Ganchen, which is part of the Italian Buddhist Union, which has been recognized officially as the representation of Buddhism in Italy, and we are one of the founder center of Italian Buddhist Union, and in May there will be programs connected with that, and so we will have a space where we want to present many things like the Sun Mandala, teaching initiation, and the Sarasvati Orchestra, for example, which is a new project which is now preparing different kind of songs and music to be presented both in that occasion and maybe in the expo time in different spaces and so on. So this is a way to present the essence of Buddhism in a different form for modern time and modern world. So this Nelso Sarasvati Orchestra is part of this project.
So we was coming in beginning Chinese talk, coming to
whatever that's giving, one section giving conference, giving to expand to generally, Tibetan Buddhism, Tibetan medicine, particularly how you bath, what bath. How we use things to do yeah. And these doctors are going to be Milano visiting, then going to be Venice visiting, then going to Napoli University, which is somewhere else. So those doctors are listening to some conference there. Can be in the hospitals coming to talking
23 di aprile. So on the 22nd of the 3rd of April, we have also the project of this one Tibetan medicine hospital in Beijing. So doctor from that hospital will come to visit Albagnano and Milano too. And so they will talk about Tibetan medicine, specifically about these hot baths with herbs that they use as a curing method. And then they will visit Venice and the University of Naples also. And so these are doctors coming from this hospital in Beijing. So the 22nd, 23rd of April, we will have a visit of some doctors from the Tibetan Medical Hospital in Beijing, and they will talk about Tibetan medicine and this system of healing with hot baths with herb. And then they will visit also Milano here, and Venice, and the University of Naples. Also, they will have a conference there.
So, I'm using a lot of this. One side, maybe I need, yes, I'm all the man. Other side, I message to you to be, I'm standing here, one will wait, a woman doctors. So, need to be this uniform, using to wear your pen. Very useful because Tibetan medical says hot water is first medicine. This is hot water. So it's useful for any pan. So, but be careful to how much put inside, if gas came out, digging, otherwise to pull into, not digging, something is broken, is coming also some difficult problems. So it's very good for you, for everyone to useful. So any pad, this is painkiller.
Dice anche che appunto io uso molto queste bolle dell'acqua calda, queste borse dell'acqua calda, e perché comunque nella medicina tibetana l'acqua calda è considerata la prima medicina, la medicina fondamentale. Dice, in realtà appunto io sono una persona anziana, quindi uso queste cose, però lo faccio anche per suggerire a voi questo metodo che è molto, certe volte molto utile quando abbiamo dolori in differenti parti del corpo. Avere questo con noi ci aiuta appunto a superare queste difficoltà. L'unica cosa è che dobbiamo stare attenti, ogni tanto si rompono, come è successo ieri sera, però. E quindi non bisogna riempire troppo, io l'avevo riempita troppo, e quindi stare attenti perché è molto utile, ma appunto va usata nel modo giusto. So, Rinja said that I'm using these water bottles for different, because I'm older now and I have different pain sometimes, but this is a suggestion for you also to make use of those, because it's like in the Tibetan medicine, they say the fundamental cure is the hot water. So this is a good example how to use hot water, but at the same time you need to be careful not to feel too much, because sometimes you get burnt. And so, but anyway, is a suggestion for you to use that. This is the curative method that I use.